I love layering plugins. So it's every little piece is doing something important at a low level. And when you add it all up, the difference is huge. The vocals recorded for an M49 going through a Neve 1073 preamp. I mean, it's our favorite mic for so many reasons. It's Howard's favorite number. He has it tattooed on him, which I learned last stream. And so did Mum. And then a Tube Tech, most likely a Tube Tech. I've put it through a tiny bit of Melodyne as well, I think, just to touch it up. If anything, I was probably doing timing in Melodo. A lot of plugins on this bus. So I'll give you a blast of it before.
I've been working and I spent my time dreaming about how I could ease my mind.
With all the plugins.
I've been working and I spent my time dreaming about how I could ease my mind. Breakbeat dance feels like I can fly.
Sick. So upfront, loads of compression. Probably sounds a bit over-compressed on its own, but in with all those breakbeat slamming drums. Just wanted her to be like really upfront. You know, if you take the breakbeat out, it's pretty, you know, straight 4/4 beat. But, you know, with the addition of all of those breakbeats that we started with, it sounds super busy. This was going to be a single, this song, always. So it's going to be on the radio and, you know, you need your vocal right up front for all those things. Let's just take one of her vocals then, this one, which is slightly panned to the left.
I've been working.
Going into a Tube Tech again. So it's like the second Tube Tech, if you like.
Dreaming about how I could ease my mind. Breakbeat dance.
Just, yeah, lightly 3 dB of compression, nothing too crazy. And then I've got this Surfer EQ on it, which I absolutely love.
Dreaming about how I could ease my mind. Breakbeat dance feels like I can fly.
That is so clever. It's moving with the lowest note in her voice. So instead of having to duck out like 5 different notches, you just do one and it moves around with it. It's so clever, man. I love it for vocals, for, you know, if you want to just change the tone of a vocal, not have to put big slopes and scoops in. Then we are doing some regular EQ. Just taking out a resonance here that I didn't like.
Dreaming about...
that thing.
Breakbeat dance.
Thought about boosting the highs here, but I've ended up bypassing it.
Dreaming about how
again, taking out more low mids. Just didn't need it. Once you got 2 vocals in there, the low mids double up immediately. So took some out. Gem dopamine, giving some highs. Not much, just a little bit.
Dreaming about how I could ease my mind.
Just a little splash. Then with de-essing, because those S's are a little bit prominent.
Dreaming about how I could ease my mind. Breakbeat dance feels like
Saturn as well, clean tube.
Dreaming about how I could ease my mind. Breakbeat dance feels like
so you can only hear it when I really pump it, but it is doing stuff. That is the channel plugins done, and then we got a hell of a lot of bus plugins. So now you're hearing both the vocals with no bus processing.
Mine, breakbeat dance.
So those are both getting compressed again by LA76.
Mine, breakbeat dance feels like mine. Breakbeat dance feels like I can fly.
Super low, it's just catching the very highest of peaks. Decapitator is next. That is going to be adding some distortion.
Mine, breakbeat dance feels like I can fly.
So I'm actually pumping that really hard, but I've only got it on about 20%. And that's just to add some grit underneath the vocals, some like radio lo-fi frequencies. The post-chorus of the song is like really lo-fi and really distorted. So I just was trying to kind of get the listener ready for that. You know, I didn't want to just go totally clean, totally distorted. This is like a halfway house between both.
Mine, breakbeat dance feels like I can fly.
Love that. Some more EQ, getting rid of some more resonance.
Mine. Feels like I can fly.
Minor stuff here. It's like 1 or 2 dB. Nothing really.
Mine, breakbeat dance feels like
a bit more de-essing going on up here. Then we're going inflator and then some more de-essing.
Mine, breakbeat dance feels like I can fly. Give me some space so I can close.
You know, these are all really subtle moves, guys. Look, with 2-3 dB on the de-esser, you know, this is giving 2-3 dB of inflator. I love layering plugins. So it's every little piece is doing something important at a low level. And when you add it all up, the difference is huge. Then we got soothe.
Mine, breakbeat dance feels like.
See how it just caught that on beat, breakbeat.
Mine, breakbeat.
so good, man. Up there, it's just gone.
Break beat, dance.
And then delay, reverb effects, basically. Got some automation on this Echo Boy. It's kind of filling in the gaps in between her where she stops singing. So you can see that wet and dry knob just move.
I've been working and I spent my time dreaming about how I could ease my mind. Break beat, dance, feels like I can fly.
Bit of reverb.
I've been working and I spent my time dreaming about how I...
And then like a super short slapback again.
It's
adding
my
to that
kind of slapback.
Yeah, that's Howard's favorite thing, is to put like an 80s short delay on every vocal ever.
I've been working and I spent my time.
And then we got, wow, quite a lot of EQ there. I'm surprised that's there. I probably wouldn't do this anymore. I probably wouldn't have that. I don't think it's needed.
I've been working and I spent my time dreaming about how I could ease my mind.
Just taking out more resonance, again, making it sound a little bit more like a small radio speaker vibe. These things here are all just reverbs, delays, like slightly more subtle reverbs and delays. And then sidechain. Quite heavy sidechain on this because it's really thumping tune.
And my time dreaming about how I could ease my mind.
There you go, you get it. That's the lead vocal in both verses. And it's all very subtle moves, guys. At the end of the day, you know, if you're choosing bad sounds, no amount of bus processing is going to make it sound good. You got to just have a sick beat there in the first place. Get your sounds right, get the groove right. You know, all of those things there, that adds 10% at the end. You know, it just polishes it all off. Get the idea right first. There's a few BVs here where she says dance. We just kind of layered that up. We thought it would sound cool.
Break beat, dance, feels like I can dance.
That was one thing, wasn't it, Howard, that we were certain we wanted to get Khalees talking on this tune, not
yeah.
just singing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Because she's got such a cool talking voice, like the stuff she does in Millionaire.
Yeah, that's kind of half talking, half singing. So raspy, like so much mm-hmm. flavor in there. It's great. Here's the chorus. I'm not going to go through all the plugins because they're basically the same. It's just wider. It's got more parts to it, more panning. There's some whispers in there as well.
Don't look in the crowd.
They
even when the lights come down. I like to dance like I'm alone in the room. I'm here tonight, baby, to do what I do. Yeah.
Oh, and we got those whispers there, panned right, left and right. Oh, look at this, Howard, panned to 49 left and right. I wonder why.
Yes, yes, that will have been my doing.
It's the correct amount. Yeah, and there's a low octave in there as well. But I think that's just a little altar boy sending to bus 9.
Baby, even when the lights come.
So, you know, sounds a bit shitty on its own, but in the mix, just fills that space nicely.
I don't look in the crowd, baby, even when the lights come down. I like to dance like a...
You know, there's such a big bass line in this song, that frequency like is full enough. So this is my favorite part of the song, the post-chorus. Howard, do you want to tell the people a little bit of why this is so special, this post-chorus?
So we decided we wanted to make Khalees's vocals sound like it was coming through like a megaphone or something. We didn't have a megaphone, so we asked Ira, our engineer at Capitol Studios, where like Frank Sinatra and loads of amazing people have recorded. We were like, what's the worst microphone you've got in the building? They were like, what, the worst one? We were like, yeah, the worst possible one. He like went out and asked around, and he came back with this thing that was like, it's about like, I don't know, probably the size of like a mouse for a computer or something like that. There's no stand. You had to just hold it. But it's for a harmonica, right?
This beauty. It literally captures like no low mids at all and
yeah,
no super
it's a
highs.
Horrible, horrible sounding microphone. And so we used it for Khalees.
Yeah, so we used it on Khalees. She was laughing her head off because we were saying that all that stuff in front of her. Just being like, hey, can you get the worst mic? And she'd be like, sorry, what? Can I not use Frank Sinatra's mic? Like, no, you should use this mic. That's how we managed to achieve this sound, or at least how we started to achieve. There's a lot of processing on it still. I will bypass everything.
You make me watch a step when you move.
So my favorite thing about it is the plosives on the P's. That's where you can hear it like breaking up.
You make me watch a step when you move.
Just sounds like she's talking for a walkie-talkie.
Make me watch a step when you move.
So yeah, you can hear all that distortion. So this was recorded just right in front of the speakers. Mm-hmm. We didn't even put her in the vocal booth. She was just
oh, that's right. That's what we're hearing.
So you're hearing probably the kick drum.
You make me watch a step when you move. Now what you're doing is making me move with you.
Yeah, on each track, I've taken out some rumble, compressing them.
You make me watch a step when you move.
No, not that hard. Overdrive.
You make me watch a step when you move.
Bit of de-essing.
You make me watch a step when you move.
And then we're really getting into the lo-fi vibes. So this is where Decapitator's really taking the lead.
You make me watch a step when you move. Now what you're doing is making me move with you.
Extra crackle, extra distortion. Then more compression.
You make me watch a step when you move.
Now we're really getting to the forefront of it.
You make me watch a step when you move.
Some pretty brutal EQ. This is what's really making it sound lo-fi.
You make me watch a step when you move.
So for me, boosting anything around 1K always makes things sound like a little old radio.
Now what you're doing is making me move.
And I'm just boosting all those nice distorted, crackly imperfections up here. Going into inflator.
You make me watch a step when you move.
Really distorting the inflator as well.
You make me watch a step when you move.
De-esser and soothe.
Now what you're doing is making me move with you.
Soothe's doing a lot actually here.
You make me watch a step when you move.
Really helping it not sound too ouch. Couple of delays and then it's reverb and then what's that? Bit crusher.
You make me watch a step when you move.
Finishing off the demonic vibe. Wow, even more EQ. Yeah, I absolutely mangled this one.
You make me watch a step when you move.
Fully in 1940s gramophone territory, which is what I wanted.
You make me watch a step when you move.
So there you go. That is that's how we did it.
Watch a step when you move.
Why so many effects? Well, hopefully by going through them one by one, as I just did, it is now clear. They're all, you know, doing minor things, all adding up to one big effect. Like I said, it's,
you make me watch.
That's with the effects and here's without.
You make me watch a step when you move.
I mean, there's no comparison, is there really? They're so different.